Thursday, March 2nd. It's gray. Not too cold. Feels like a little mist. Every Thursday and or Friday this winter, except for one, was somewhat wet with white in front and behind. And this week is no exception. Let's go check where I checked this rock yesterday. See if there's anything new on there. Yep, picked up just about maybe a quarter of an inch of snow with a temperature near 32 down here. I think there's about an inch up on the mountain. And technically it is snowing, it's certainly snowing harder off in New Hampshire and Maine this morning. So it's day 11 in a row with snow somewhere in New England. Today, New Hampshire and Maine are doing better than Vermont, at least with the warmer air this morning. Not much cold around, just cold enough for snow. Mount Washington, you can see the thermal profile is cold. There's the NAM showing the really overachieving rain. Where'd this come from in southern New England? And snow across New Hampshire and Maine. NAM says 15 to 20 inches for Mount Washington. I think that's about three times too high. But as colder air comes back in aloft this afternoon, we are going to see a burst of snow here in the Green Mountains too. Where, as you've heard, conditions yesterday were the best they can be, so there's only one way to go from there. Today, they winched hayride, winch groomed. So I might try and do a spin on hayride and do a much more in-depth out the door weather and more. This is more of just a sort of an analysis with a wave going by today. Colder air comes in tonight, and then the stage is set for our Friday night, Saturday, Miller B nor'easter, which the trend has been to lift that a little further north than what we were thinking a couple days ago. So that's great news for the Canadian border, but that also means the mix line is going to come farther north. So it's going to be a funky storm with cold wind, white and wet Friday night into Saturday. Sunday looks pretty good. It looks like it's going to be dry. Maybe the first day without any snow anywhere in New England in quite a while. That would be since the Sunday before last Monday, which is 12 days ago. Anyhow, this is a quick one. I'm going to do a little skiing, and I'll come back with more in-depth, probably in the format of a snowcast later on this afternoon after I check the conditions up top. Chickadees, chickadees. See the chickadee? I love it that they have bird feeders here. All right, much more later. It's just a quickie. Look up toward hayride, you can't really even see it in the fog, so not an ideal morning. But usually when it warms up, the conditions are pretty nice. Until it gets colder again, anyway.
What was that yawn for?
I like this form of a texture check to see what it does. That didn't work out.
Try that again.
Okay, see that? An inch on top of groomers. That is perfect. So did you take a run yet today?
Yeah, I just did one.
Using Braille?
What was it? Yeah, Braille, right. Pretty tough to see where you're going this morning.
Yeah, how was it underfoot?
It was awesome.
Yeah.
Yep, nice edgeable, a little cream on top. It was fun. Can't wait to do another one in the fog.
I think hayride is around here somewhere. Oh yeah, right there. No problem. Feels good.
Need somebody else to help.
Hey, ride.
TK!
Ghost just yelled TK. Love when that happens. No glaze on the chair, so we haven't had any liquid precipitation yet. And you can see what you're doing for the bottom 700 feet. You know what I like to say? Fog is future snow. And we are expecting another burst of snow this afternoon. Just past 9 a.m., we get
pingy precipitation. Can you hear it bouncing off my goggles? Maybe a raindrop in there, but mostly little ice balls. I think we're starting to transition to cooler aloft.
Can't really see what you're doing, but great job grooming. It's nice. I love the prime frosticles.
Got myself in somewhat of a precarious position, so I'll just stop and enjoy nature. Looks like maybe a snow hare coming out of there. And then the spiked frost. Is this, pardon the expression, hoar frost? I didn't name it. Just enjoying it.
And just past 9 o'clock, that's what I call 10,000 feet before breakfast. And yes, I did get some goggles, and yes, there's a tiny bit of ice accreting on them. So we got a tiny mix right now. It wouldn't be a Thursday or Friday without at least a little funk to the hydro meteors. Really nice skiing though, beautiful, even though you can't really see what you're doing up top.